Hi, welcome to Fix Home Network. Today I will show you how to set up the Linksys WRT1900ACS router. In this video, I will show you how to set up this router without installation CD or smart setup wizard, and what is the default password of this router. I will also show you how to set up the guest network access for this router and how to upgrade the firmware of this router. So let's start with how to set up this router without installation CD or smart setup wizard. Connect the internet port on the Linksys router to your modem. So on the router, there are basically five ports. One is internet or WAN port, and the other four ports are Ethernet ports where you can connect your computer. I have another video which will show you how to connect the router to the modem and the computer to the router. Here is the link. You can see the link. You can click on the link and watch that video. So first of all, you will need to connect your computer to the router and the modem to the router. Once you connect the computer and the router to the modem, open the Internet Explorer or Internet browser on your computer. It can be Safari, it can be Firefox, or any other Internet browser you have on your computer. Open it, and in the address bar, type in the number 192.168.1.1. 192.168.1.1 is the default IP address of the Linksys router. It will ask you for the username and password. The default password of this router is admin, A-D-M-I-N. Leave the username blank. If that doesn't work, then try admin in the username and try admin in the password also. If that also doesn't work, then you may need to reset the router. If you're setting this router for the first time, then press and hold the reset button on the router for 15 seconds. Release the reset button. Unplug the power cable and plug it back in. Wait for 30 seconds. Just remember, if you reset the router, it will come back to the factory default settings and you will need to reconfigure it, or you will lose all the settings of this router. So let's try to open the setup page again. Type in 192.168.1.1 and try the password admin. It will open the setup page of the Linksys router. Now all these steps you will find on my website also, that is www.fixhomenetwork.com/blog. Here you will see the link. You can click on the link and you will see all these steps on the website also. So now let's open the setup page of the router. So when you open the setup page of the router, you will see the screen like this. This is basically the setup page of the Linksys router, where you can change the settings of this router. First of all, we will need to change the internet connection settings of this router so that this router will be able to communicate with the modem and your main computer will be able to access internet through the router. So we'll change the internet connection settings of Linksys WRT1900AC router. In this video, I will show you how to change the settings for the cable internet service provider, the DSL internet service provider with PPPoE connection, and the static IP address given by internet service provider. So let's start with the cable internet service provider settings. You will see connectivity option here. Click on connectivity. Now here you will see internet settings. Click on internet settings. For the cable internet service provider, keep the connection type on automatic configuration, DHCP. Now here you will see the option MAC address clone. Enable the MAC address clone and click on the button clone my PC's MAC, and then click on apply. All right, so these are the only settings that you will need to change for the cable internet service provider. Now let's move on to DSL internet service provider with PPPoE connection. For this connection type, you will need to change the internet connection to PPPoE. Change it to PPPoE. Here you will need to enter the username and password given by your internet service provider. This is basically just the email address and password given by your internet service provider. So enter the username password, the correct username password, and click on apply. All right, so this is done with the PPPoE connection. Now move on to static IP. change the internet connection type to static IP address, enter the IP address, subnet mask, default gateway, DNS1 and DNS2. All these IP addresses will be given by your internet service provider. So you just need to enter those IP addresses here and click on apply. All right, so these are the basic internet settings that we need to change for the internet type of connection. Once you are done this with these settings, your main computer will be able to access internet through the router. So just try to access internet through the router on the main computer. If you're able to go online on that computer, then these settings are correct. Now let's move on to wireless settings. Here you will see the wireless option, the wireless icon. Click on the wireless icon. Now on this screen, you will see two different wireless settings. One for 2.4 gigahertz wireless network and the other one for 5 gigahertz wireless network. So this router is capable of providing you two different wireless networks. One is 2.4 gigahertz and the other one is 5 gigahertz. If you want, you can turn off any one of them. Now, first of all, change the network name. Keep it different for both the wireless networks so that you can identify which one is 2.4 gigahertz and which one is 5 gigahertz. And change the password. You can keep the same password for both the wireless networks. Once you change the name and the password, click on apply. So your wireless network is also ready. Now go to your wireless computer or any wireless device and try to connect to the wireless network. You will see the new wireless network. It will ask you for the password. Just enter the same password that you just created and try to connect. Once you are able to connect, you will be able to access internet on the wireless computer also. So we are done with the internet settings, the wireless network settings. Now let's move on to the guest network access. This router is capable of giving you guest network access. So if you have any guests coming in, you can allow them to connect to the guest network instead of main network. So on the setup page of the router, you will see this option, guest access. Click on guest access, turn it on. If you want to on, you can turn it on. Now this is the section where you can change the guest network settings. Click on edit. Now change the network name. If you want to change, you can change. If you want to disable any one of them or enable any one of them, you can enable or disable them. And you can create a password for the guest network. And here is the setting where you can change the number of guests to be connected to the wireless network. So you can allow only 10 guests to connect to the network. Or if you want, you can completely turn it off. All right, once you are done with the settings, you can just click on OK and it will change the settings. Now let's move on to the next section, how to upgrade the firmware of your router. For this, you can go to connectivity tab. First of all, you will need to download the latest firmware of this router from the Linksys website. The website will be www.linksys.com. Just go to the website and download the firmware of your router. Save it on the computer. Your computer must be connected to the router with the Ethernet cable. So do not try to upgrade the firmware using wireless computer. Just make sure that it is connected with the Ethernet cable. Now on this page, you will see the option firmware update. Here is an option to choose the file that you have downloaded. Select the file and click on start. It will start upgrading the firmware of the router. Once it is done, it will show you the firmware upgrade is successful. All right, so this is how you can change the or upgrade the firmware of the router. Now how to change the password of this router. Here is an option, router password, on the basic connectivity tab. Click on edit, enter the current password, the new password, and confirm the new password and click on apply. So this will basically change the password of the router. So just remember, this is not a wireless network password. This is just a password to access the router settings page. So the wireless password is different than the router password. So just remember the password if you change them. All right, so we are done with the settings of this router. Just try to connect to the wireless network and see if that works. If you have any questions or if you have any queries, you can leave comment below, or you can go to our website www.fixhomenetwork.com/blog and leave comment on that website also. We will try to answer your queries as soon as possible. So thanks for watching.